Looking good is an art, but today, it's also a science. Thanks to some insight from physicist Jessica Esquivel. Take a look.
Oh, I'm just checking the optics of my makeup. I have to tell you, I'm not really sure what that means, but our next guest, Dr. Jessica Esquivel, who is a particle physicist, is going to teach me all about the physics behind makeup.
Come on in.
But before she can teach me about makeup, she has to teach me what a particle physicist is.
Being a particle physicist means that I study the smallest building blocks of the universe with the biggest detectors in the country. We think of detectors like big old microscopes that we use to look at things that are really, really small.
And although this branch of physics is highly theoretical, it does have some practical uses.
Particle physicists actually invented the internet. We wanted a way to transfer data from one site to another. And that is the beginnings of the internet, and now we use it all the time in every device.
So besides completely changing the world, particle physicists are also changing how we see the world. Today, Jessica's going to show me how light particles can interact with the building blocks of makeup to create really cool effects.
Why don't you put a little bit of pigment on the back of your hand, and I'll do the same.
I think I'm gonna try this blue.
Do you see how shiny that is?
This is awesome.
So it's because of a mineral called mica. And what cosmetic scientists do is grind this up into a fine powder, add a little bit of pigment to it, and you get this really amazing, shiny, shimmery powder that we're seeing right here.
Wow, that is so interesting.
So mica is birefringent. You can send unpolarized light, so light that goes up, down, left, and right, through mica, and what comes out of it is actually light that's split in two.
Birefringent? Huh? It's a scientific term for something that separates one ray of light into two rays of light that travel at different speeds. To demonstrate this, Jessica and I hold up polarizer filters which divide light waves into a single plane.
So what I want you to do is hold your filter up and tell me what you see.
I see the light shining through.
Okay, so now start rotating your filter.
Oh wow, it stopped the light.
The filters are only allowing light that is moving horizontally to pass through. So when I turn my filter vertically, it stops the light.
So now let's get our mica sheet and put it in between our polarizers and see what happens.
Wow, that is so cool. I can see so many different colors. There's like red and blue and green.
The ability of mica to split light into two beams is what allows makeup to shimmer. And the reason we're seeing color is because the mica acts like a prism and reflects the different colors that make up white light at different angles. The earliest use of mica to make shiny colors can be tracked back to cave paintings. So if mica is old school makeup, then the new school of makeup is photonic crystals, which are tiny sculptures that can manipulate light.
You can kind of imagine it like a little cube with crystals, and it has these things called band gaps. And what that does is allow certain wavelengths of light to pass through the photonic crystal, but blocking all of the other wavelengths.
So scientists could create a photonic crystal that would only allow the wavelength of a certain color to pass through. They wouldn't need to add pigment like they do with mica.
So instead of having this really amazing royal blue, which we've had to add pigment to the mica to give it that shimmer, we can just have a swatch of photonic crystals on our eye that has a band gap that will only allow this blue out.
This is maybe makeup technology of the future.
Definitely.
Photonic crystals can be found all around in nature. For example, they're in butterfly wings, peacock feathers, and beetle scales. Now that we know how light interacts with makeup to give us that luminous look, it's time for Jessica and I to get our glow up on.
I love the green and the blue you used.
Thank you.
It matches your hair color.
Yes, yes, yes.
Who knew that creating fun looks with makeup had so much to do with particles and light? So the next time you put on makeup and think your look is really lit, you'll know it's all because of science.